Well, also because I guess we don't have to sit around for the credits. Welcome to Throwback Galaxy.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's why I wanted to... Wait, did I need fire?
Nah, you don't... You actually don't get any power-ups here, and you don't need any power-ups here.
Huh.
It's Welcome to Throwback Galaxy, a throwback to a game.
Kirby's Dream Land, probably.
The game ago.
It's a throwback to Kirby's Dream Land and not Kirby's Adventure?
No, this is just a throwback to Kirby's Adventure. Which, by technicality, if we're playing the original version of this game, was just a game ago.
No, because Kirby's Adventure is the original version. Is this a throwback to... Is the game that this is remaking, so is this a throwback to that, or...
This level is a throwback to Kirby's Adventure, just like it was... No, this is the...
Because Kirby's Dream Land came before Kirby's Adventure.
This is a throwback to Kirby's Dream Land on the Game Boy.
Okay, never mind then. I was gonna say, that's the other reason I thought, wait to do this level in the final part, because it's a throwback.
Yeah, it's a throwback to just a game ago.
That's why none of the enemies give you copies, because Kirby's Adventure was the game that had the copy ability.
It's also not particularly difficult. Hell, I think we could have squeezed this in the last part.
Probably, but... You know. I actually don't know, but... Hey. It's fun having nostalgia in the last part.
Yeah, again, this is nostalgia for just a game ago, though. This isn't like... is not Throwback Galaxy like it was in actual Galaxy 2, where it was a whole 64 level.
They just want to have fun.
This happens in every game, though. There's always a throwback to this level.
Well, I don't have an answer.
I can see that you don't. Yeah, we definitely could have fit this in the last part.
Oh, well.
Oh, well, what? There's nothing there but that!
I'm just checking. So where is the secret, then?
It's in the moon. You've got to fly all the way up there and go in the moon like you did in the original version. I'd recommend taking a power-up here, though, because the next thing we do is a boss. Yeah, the moon right there.
Boink.
Hooray.
Why did they give you a Maximino if this thing refills your health?
I don't know. Why do they do everything in this game?
Why is down up?
Now, do you want to fight DDD with the cutter, or do you think you can use it for a little while and then spit it at him?
I think I could use the cutter.
Alright, boys, final boss time.
And this time it actually starts as being DDD.
Just start throwing shit at him.
I love his face when he gets hit.
Ah. Oh. Damn. Just wait. I love how every hit, Oh yeah, just spit it back at him.
There we go.
I love how every hit resets his pattern.
That just reminded me of Melee, of course, because this is Fountain of Dreams.
And now for the final cutscene of the game. Apparently, Kirby's about to put the Star Rod back after collecting 6 of them for some reason. Or is it pieces of the Star Rod, I guess? I don't know.
I guess pieces. What is DDD doing?
He's trying to stop him.
I didn't know he could slide like that, though.
Because apparently putting the Star Rod back would bring the darkness back. So DDD, in all his infinite wisdom, removed the Star Rod without telling anybody. And so Kirby just thought he was doing something bad. So now we gotta fight this ultimate evil thing. I think it's called Nightmare?
I don't even know the name. I'm just nervous because this part actually can be a little difficult.
You're fine. Yeah, so this whole game is because DDD knew of something evil that was hiding in the fountain and didn't tell anybody.
Funny thing, I actually just realized this since I mentioned this is difficult. Funny thing I realized about Kirby games. They're always, very easy, but then the boss fight just, ups the difficulty, 2 notches or something. I'm like,
that's... Are we talking about just final bosses or bosses in general?
Final bosses.
This is on a time limit, by the way. If you fall and hit the ground, you lose.
Mm.
But I've never done that purposefully, so yeah. I had to actually look it up. Now, fuck this fight, by the way. Because Kirby doesn't have a normal jump in this fight. He just has that star jump. Where he spins with a rod. Hmm. And it does nothing. Now, in the anime, this character is actually the main villain. His name's Nightmare. Yeah, his name's Nightmare. You have to wait for him to open his cloak and then hit the tornado that's his body.
I got a few hits.
It does more damage if you hit him like that than as opposed to the jump.
I'm only doing that so I could actually get
up.
Yeah,
I know, reach him.
Shit.
Yeah, that one's tricky. That one's tricky. I'll give you that one. Duck, 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 duck. Or just avoid him.
Somehow that worked.
Start flying. When you see him just like ascend in the air real fast and then ascend again, that's your cue to jump.
Damn it.
That was not your cue to jump.
Sorry.
Well, at least now you start this fight with a full health bar. Like right, now, cool. Start flying, start flying, start flying.
Damn. I was gonna say, I was like, does this mean I have to start all the way from the beginning?
Thank God, no. Did that hit him?
I think?
It didn't do any damage, though.
Like, a light bit? Sorry, I got nervous about the beam, and I...
Yeah, I could tell you.
Down.
I could tell. Alright, start, go.
I was pointing the wrong way. Oh, I hit
him. You got him there.
I hit him
out of pure luck. Alright, get ready.
Oh shit, how did that not reach, though?
Three strikes, you're out!
I was like, how did that not hit?
He has a huge chin, by the way.
I just noticed he has a huge chin.
Evil, thy name is Chin. You have to literally, like, jump at the very last second.
Victory, thy name is Plankton.
Sheldon. There we go.
Right.
I think, like, two more hits, maybe? Three?
I hope so. Also, that light was intense on my eyes.
Yeah. Be ready. Here it goes again. One, two, three, jump. There you go.
Cool, alright.
That little sliver of health. He does one attack at the very end where he, like, goes really high up and then falls down with his head first. I don't want to call it a desperation attack because it's not like it does anything extra. Here it is. There.
Okay.
Game over.
Done. Guess that wasn't as hard as I thought.
And apparently that destroys him forever.
Yeah. The power of the wand.
That's it? I think you have to hit the button.
I was gonna say, that would suck if it was just like, and then took you back to the menu.
And now, just like Sonic Adventure 2, half the moon is gone.
And thus, the crescent was formed. Yeah. Kirby said, let there be moon.
Our hero, Kirby, has fought bravely, but DDD didn't mean any harm for once.
With his hammer, I never believe that.
He wasn't trying to harm the Fountain of Dreams. It all began when the nightmares appeared in the fountain.
I was gonna say, when you say that, like, he wasn't trying to harm it, I'm just like, when I see his hammer, I never believe that.
So the nightmares were wreaking havoc on Dreamland. And when he hid the star rod, the power source of the Fountain of Dreams, he hid it away from the nightmares.
Safely, quote unquote.
Borrowing his power, he shot you out of his mouth.
I was gonna say, I don't know if I really borrowed it. Fluff up your pillow and get ready for a good night's sleep. Bitch, don't tell me what to do.
Yeah. So, I think this whole story would have been avoided if he just told Kirby what was going on. Because apparently Meta Knight knew as well, but didn't say anything.
Hmm.
And now, this is the end of the game. The dreams return to everybody.
And Kirby
gives you a wave for playing.
Because that's what they always do.
Thanks! Alright, final thoughts?
I mean, I still love this game.
I think it was definitely the first game Kirby game we both played, right?
Yeah.
So it holds some nostalgia there. And this is just the game showing you other ways you could achieve the fights.
And I was going to say, even for my nostalgia, I still think it holds up very well. Even, I think, as much as I complained about the controls, I think that's more the fault of the Wii U as opposed to the game as a whole. If you play it on a GBA, specifically an SP, don't play it on the original.
I think we've made a point of that.
But if you play it on a GBA, it probably plays better. Or if you... I don't know if you can, but if there's a controller you can use for this other than the gamepad...
Like the Pro Controller, maybe?
Yeah, maybe. Maybe you'll have a better time with it. Or, if anything, it feels like this is the kind of game that could work well if you're, like, using a Wii Remote held sideways. Since it is a 2D game.
I was about to say, a two-player game.
Well, it could have been, but I don't know if you can play two-player in it now, on the Wii U.
No, you can't. I think you could play two-player in any Game Boy Advance game that's on the Wii U.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, the game itself, like I said, still fantastic. Probably the closest to a 10 out of 10 that I'd give to a Kirby game, to be honest.
Really?
I might
the other games you played.
I might even give it a 10. But...
I think the other games do it better, though, because at least in those games, you could take more than one hit before losing a power.
Again, that speaks more to time as opposed to anything else, because obviously this is an old game. Obviously things will get better.
Again, it was the first of its kind, so yeah.
And... I still think it's amazing, and I definitely recommend checking it out. Again, I don't know if me complaining about the controls was the fault of the Wii U pad itself, or just my pad from being used so much, or what, I don't know. But, regardless, I still highly recommend you give the game a shot if you haven't already. Even if it's old and some people might think it's dated, it still holds up very well.
It holds up fine, I just think the other games do a better job. Now you can play sub-game Boss Endurance.
Which is pretty much exactly what it sounds like, a boss rush.
But without a break in between for health.
There also is supposedly... It said pick extra from the... Oh, play with half your health.
Yeah, and then you can play the Meta Knight mode.
Oh, wow. Well, I ain't playing with half the health. I'll give you that much.
And I also ain't playing with Meta Knight, because that means we have to beat the mode with half health. And then play with Meta Knight, who has half health, and is just nothing more than Sword. Hmm. Well, that's Kirby's Nightmare in Dreamland, folks. Hope you had fun.
I did. Except for when Mike was getting angry with me.
Oh, shut up!
I'm just saying.
Alright, for the next game in the Quarantine Chronicles...
I don't think we've revealed what it is. I don't even know what it is. I don't know if you want to...
I've never seen this before.
I don't know if you want to keep it a secret. Maybe it'd be fun if you kept it a secret, but if you're just dying to blurt it out, I guess go ahead.
Well, you know exactly what it is.
I don't, actually.
All right,
keep it a secret.
All right, well, we'll see you guys the next time we do the Quarantine Chronicles. It's going to be another longer game, though. I'll admit that.
That's all that's the only hint we're giving.
Yeah, well, since we just did two back-to-back fucking 10-minute games, essentially.
Yeah.
My next game is going to be a beaver.
That might be fun, hopefully.
All right, well, I'm Mike.
I'm Matt.
Have a great night, take care, and good night.
See you guys.
Wash your ass.